welcome to the next episode of Travel for Fun. But maybe first thing first, my name is Karolina and I will show you most of popular tourist attraction in Greece. Meanwhile, Krzysztof will show you Greece from the other side. So today we're chilling out. We're on Syntagma, one of the main squares in Athens.
I think it's called Plateia in Greek.
Yeah, this is Plateia, place where people going out to meet, chill, drink, eat, whatever, everything. Drink specially. We're in National Park. It's quite huge, quite amazing, and
there is a turtle.
There are a living turtle in here. They have their own mini lake and it's amazing. And we're going to show you that.
Today we decide to go and see. And then we figure out we have only 2 kilometers from...
Three
kilometers from our house to
seaside.
To seaside. And there it is. You not think about anything else but eating, not mention taking the camera and filming that. And it's souvlaki. It's raw pita bread with tzatziki sauce and fries and tomato and pork meat or other meat, I think chicken, and it's delicious. I think this is the most delicious meal on the planet. And trust me, I eat a lot of. Tomorrow is something called Laiki, and it's a very big market on the street. It's really, really, really cheap.
Almost everything.
Yes, there is almost everything on Laiki.
Mostly vegetables.
But not only vegetables, I think.
Said most.
Mostly, okay. And if you want to buy something for it, it's a really good idea, because when you go to the shop, the price is so high, then I'm not so high, but higher than on Laiki, and you save money. I think it's good value.
Reasons we had to go back to Poland, but it's temporary situation. Meanwhile, when we are in Poland or Spain or wherever, we decide to talk you about few things could maybe, I don't know, funny, strange for most European people, but for Greeks are completely natural. For example, orange and mandarin trees, they growing along the road, because
in Spain is also
yeah, but I don't know how smoke situation looks in Spain, but in Greek is huge problem, and orange and mandarin trees is the way to deal with smoke, and by the way it look nice
and taste terrible.
I don't taste.
Yeah, the taste of these fruits are terrible. They're so...
I don't know, I don't eat it, and...
Good for you.
I never try. Yeah, okay.
And there's a very, very good thing about Greece, I think, because of the flag. In Greece, national flag is almost everywhere, in shops, in libraries, in even in metro, in normal house,
on ships,
on food, on everything, because Greece people are very proud of their flag, and that's missing in Poland, I think. Yeah, Polish people should
learn
that, yeah, and use our flag to be proud of. Mostly and very often.
Definitely.
Yeah. We are. There's a funny thing with Polish flag. We've been on the bus a few days ago, and we have our flag with us because we're moving out from place to place. And the old man come to us and ask, "Are we coming from the? I think it's called Rising Up." Because of the flag, and so we say, "No, why?" And that was a funny situation, I think.
Really great situation in Greece is about school and relations generally between people, because school and teachers really help parents to raise their children.
Yeah, there was a funny situation also in metro. You remember that?
Yeah, when a teacher just
because, what are you doing? Stop throwing your stuff up.
Yeah, girl just throw papers or chewing gum, just everywhere.
Yeah, and then the teacher can't say, "What are you doing? Stop doing that!
Clean that!"
And she say, "Oh, okay. In Poland, it's not think about that. It's not think that
teacher
can do because of the law. And yeah. In the old time in Poland, years ago, the teacher can do that. And the people have some culture inside.
Yeah, but now it's a past.
Yeah. And this, I think, bad thing.
Amazing thing is also that it's no such thing like exclusion of older people.
Yeah.
It's totally normal to see about, I don't know, 70, 80 year old grandpa talking with a 16 year old girl and they play chess.
You know
chess.
What I mean.
No, they just drink coffee and play chess. Yeah, Greeks always drink coffee.
Yeah.
Always.
Morning,
evening, afternoon, noon.
And they leave their coffee everywhere. Everywhere. When you go, there is them.
On stairs, in
coffee.
Elevator, on streets, on trash can.
You see trash can coffee? I don't.
Yeah, I saw once. It was like.
Okay. And there's other thing. When you go to the shop, and you can see most often scooters or papaks leave it on the run next to the shop with the how you call it.
Bags with shops.
Yeah.
Whatever they to shop, bread, orange, fruit, vegetables, everything.
And the scooters or like I said, the papaks is on the run, and nobody cares about it. The man leave it, go to the shop what he need, and go back, and take scooters with this shopping things.
And no one steal it.
Yeah, no one steal it because still food in Greece is something that horrible and that nobody
it's unspeakable.
Nobody do that because it's ugh.
Stealing someone's food is like
I think they tracked that like I don't know, killing someone. Yeah.
Or worse.
Yeah.
Yeah. So don't worry about your bags because
no food bags.
Food bags. Yeah. No one will take.
Yeah. And this the funny things is the structure of the streets, because in Greece I mostly see the streets are very narrow and the sidewalks are very, very narrow. I think, I don't know, half a meter. And there's also think about that because most of all is made of the marble, the stone. Marmor in Polish. I don't know how to call it. Forgive me.
Really nice stone.
Yeah, but when the rains come and touch that really nice stone, and there is almost like a slide walk. Not a sidewalk, like slide walk. And you can touch your ass to the ground almost everywhere.
A woman with two children will not go to sidewalk, only go just along the street.
Yeah, and there's a there's a good thing with that, because in Athens, where we are, people on the cars or on the motorbikes, they don't drive really fast because of people on the street and because of children on the street, and because of out of the street, because
they know like situation looks.
Yeah, and nobody horns on you because you're going on the street. It's really, really cool.
Yeah, they just go slower.
Yeah, and also police go slower, and nobody cares about few people on the street because nobody goes to the I don't know center of the street.
And blah blah blah. There is why people don't go to sidewalks, only on the streets, because cars and scooters and motorcycles and papaks and bikes, they always are on sidewalks.
Yeah, they park on the sidewalks.
Yeah.
And there's one thing more we want to show you.
I think too, because there is one more about how they were in November.
Yeah.
It's temperature about 22 degrees and 30 actually.
Yeah.
And this is winter for them, so they wear fluffy jackets, caps, gloves, and they are freezing.
And one time lady asked Carolina in IKEA about where you come from.
Yeah, she asked me did I come from Siberia or Russia, because it was 23 degrees about, and I was in short trousers, and she asked me because for her it's cold, and this is it was strange for her, for me also.
Yeah.
No, really, try to imagine that you're in bathroom washing your hands, and some lady ask you, did you come from Siberia? Oh, I do not recommend that.
And the last thing is about the format of the Travel for Fun channel. Because this is first time we came with camera, and we do not decide how the format will be looks like. For now it's like you see video from Greece and us talking about Greece, but we don't know how it will be in the future.
Yeah, next episode will be an experiment. We will be talking in Polish,
our native language. Because of that, because we normally not speaking English, we simply don't
speak good.
Yeah.
Thank you. Here.
Slowly, I think is the one. And we try to make experiment with that. We make another episode in Polish language with English subtitles, and we find out how it will be.
Yeah, you can also tell us what you think. It's better in English or in Polish,
or
just let us know. Okay,
so let us know what you think about
in which language,
what format for the Travel for Fun should be.
Yeah,
and let us know it's good idea, or this is good idea, or there is no good idea at all.
Or maybe if you have some question, what take to journey, what is really important.
What you want to hear about, and maybe something is normal for us and it's not normal for you, so ask, and we will be talking about that. And there's one thing we want to show you in the future. It's about how to travel, and we want to show you our life hacks for travel.
And in future it will be one more episode, I think it will be only about that, about one place in Greece. It's for now it's on Omonia, but they will changing the place.
No, so, don't say that.
Okay, you will know for a few months.
Yeah, and you can Google it.
It's the cube. Yes, I said it loud.
And there's one thing you probably want to know about Greece is the crisis. The crisis is a hard topic because I have my point of view. A person who lives in Poland, and now I'm here and I see crisis. And I know from here, from people I ask, they say there is a crisis. The main thing about the crisis in Greece is they, I think, lost something very important, is lost feeling belongs here, and they don't think they make it. And there's a funny thing about it, because they have money, they earn a lot of money, from my perspective. And there's something strange, because when you walk down the street, you see people don't look like they have crisis, and there's a big media information about the crisis. So I don't think they have crisis. They have crisis, but not money crisis, only feeling crisis. Greece, I think, lost their temper, and there is crisis. Okay, and there's one topic you should know about, is the refugees. But I think if I make a video about that, it will be one episode about this, only about this. But for now, I don't want to make it. I don't want to make it because I don't feel good about thing I see about the refugees, and yeah, that's it.